Hey guys, check out this new t-shirt. It's so me, I can't stand it. It is Tim Burton, and he's holding balloons of all characters from his movies. Like, there's Jack and Sally and Beetlejuice and Willy Wonka, Frank and Weenie, the Corpse Bride and the little skeleton guy from the Corpse Bride, Batman, an alien from Mars Attacks, Edward Scissorhands, the Cheshire Cat, and I can't place who this is. Like, I have no idea who that is, unless it's supposed to be the mummy from the Oyster Boy book. That's the only thing I can think of that is. But anyways, it was from Ripped Apparel, which is one of those sites that only has, like, limited time only t-shirts from artists, so I think I want to see theirs is, like, 3 days. It's either 3 days or 24 hours that the designs are up for, so I didn't even really want to show it because you can't get it anymore, but anyway, I have a big haul today. I don't know why, because I said I wasn't going to buy makeup for a while, and then I went nuts, because there's so much stuff coming out, and I will do Ulta first, I guess. I got, 2 things at Walmart, right? Did I get this at Walmart? I think I did, I don't remember, but, I got one of the new, Baby Lips lip glosses. I will say now, you don't need more than one of these because they're all sheer, like, they don't give you any color at all, but I got the glittery, kind of iridescent one because it looked pretty. This is, where's the name on this? Just a Glimmer, and this one just has, like, slight sparkle to it. It's really pretty. It looks like blue in some lights and pink in others. And I got this one because it really reminded me of one of my favorite MAC lip glasses, which was a limited edition one, of course, so you can't get it anymore. The Ethereal one? Yeah. Ethereal. Kind of looks like this, but this has more of a blue tone to it. Let me swatch it right next to there. And it's a little bit, the MAC one is more glittery, but still, it's pretty similar. So that is the Ethereal one, and that is the Maybelline one. So not, like, super similar, but it just reminded me of that one, and that was, I'm almost out of that lip gloss, so let me make sure that I do all this stuff. Next drugstore thing is something I was looking forward to. Actually, no, I did get this from Ulta. Okay, so this is from Ulta too, it was just a different order. It's one of the new True Match Lumi illuminators, right? Yeah, powder glow illuminators. I got the color Rose. These are pretty pricey for drugstore things. I think they're like 12, 13 bucks depending on where you get it, but Ulta was having a sale. It was like, I think it was 40% off L'Oreal, so I paid 7 something for this. This is really pretty as far as, like, drugstore highlighters go. You don't see them all that much, and when you do, they don't work all that great. It comes with this little pointless brush that most of their products do, and it has a nice mirror in there, but you really get, like, 4 colors, and I will show you what it looks like when it's all blended together. It's pretty smooth. It's very pretty. I've worn it a couple days now. I don't have it on today. I have something else that I'm going to show you. But it's just a very nice, subtle shimmer. It's not a super sparkly highlight. This I would suggest if you're pale like me, the Rose one, because this was just, I kept, ugh, my nails look horrible. I apologize for that. I need to paint them. But I kept looking online at swatches, and this one just seemed like the best, like, for me. The other ones are, there's one that's, like, silvery, which I didn't think would work too great, and then there's one that's gold for, like, deeper skin tone. So that's pretty nice so far. I like it a lot. Get samples all over the place here. So the other Ulta stuff, they were having buy one, get one 50% off on the Formula 1006 stuff again. You guys know I'm always raving about that, so I got 2 more of the down to the pore strips, the nose strips, because I love these. I didn't like them at first, and I explained that I was wetting them too much. You can't, like, super saturate them like you can with the Biore ones, so I was putting too much water on my nose, and it just wasn't, like, drying and working well, so the less water, the better with that. With those, you just kind of, like, press a warm washcloth on your nose and then stick it on. And then they had 2 things that I haven't tried yet. Whoa. The whole thing kind of like rubbed off. All the writing rubbed off onto this other thing I got. This is the, if I can read it, So Totally Clean Everyday Cleanser Sensitive Formula. I needed another like liquid makeup remover, so I picked this one. And it smells clean. Doesn't smell like chemically or anything. Smells pretty good. Haven't used it yet because this just came, but I love their stuff, so hopefully I will like that. And then this was a new product. Was this one new? I can't remember. They had something new. This is the Best Face Forward Daily Foaming Cleanser, Passion Fruit and Green Tea. And I do like that when Ulta ships stuff, they tape the caps closed so they can't like flip open in transit. And I haven't tried this one yet either. Oh, it's got a little piece of aluminum on here too. Ooh, that smells really good. It's very fruity. And it's just like a clear gel cleanser. I don't know how well you're gonna be able to see that. But my favorite cleanser right now that I have a couple of them, but my absolute favorite one is the Glam Glow one, the Super Mud Cleanser. And that's like $30. I try to limit using it because I don't want to use it every day and waste it. But I just need one for like my Clarisonic, so I picked this one up. It does smell really good. It just says it's a fresh foaming gel cleanser that washes away oil and impurities for a sparkling, clear complexion. It smells really good, so I'm excited to try this. I just hope that it works well for my oily skin, which all their stuff so far that I've tried on my face has worked well, so I'm hoping. This is what I have on my lips now. This is from, what is the brand? I still have the box over here. I'm saving this box because it reminds me of Beetlejuice. It's from Lunatic Cosmetic Labs. And I have never ordered from them before, but I kept seeing that these were coming out, and they finally came out. They have three shades of their Apocalyptic. There's only three shades to choose from, and they're all kind of like dark colors like this, but really cool packaging. And check out, this is the main reason I wanted it. The lipstick bullet is an actual bullet, like actually shaped like a bullet. That's just the coolest thing ever. I picked the color Bruja, which is what I have on. It's like that grayish color that's so popular now, but it's more purple toned, so I think it's a little more wearable if you're afraid of the straight on grayish colors. But I love, like, one of my favorite lipsticks right now is Ghoulish from, why am I blanking out? Ghoulish from LA Splash. I absolutely love that color. I love the grayish type colors, and this is just a nice little addition to my lipstick collection. It's not matte, it's not kiss proof, which is what I've been loving lately, but it's very creamy, and considering that it's not matte or kiss proof, it stays on a really long time, so I like this so far. Definitely check those out if you like kind of. I think the other one is like a deep red, and then they have a like a more purplish color. Don't quote me on that. I can't remember what the two other colors are, but there's only three colors. So now we have one thing from MAC. I did get a little sample with my order of strobe cream, which I've never tried before, but I thought this was a cute little sample. And I ordered a lipstick from the, I don't know how to pronounce this, Gian Battista Valli collection. I know I've complained about having troubles ordering from MAC collections before, but this was ridiculous. They recently changed their website, and it was just crashing all over the place. I couldn't get through. It took me forever, but I finally got the one color that I wanted, which was Bianca B, and it's probably something I'm never gonna wear, but I wanted the pink MAC lipstick tube. I know that sounds ridiculous, but you know what? This is gonna be a color that I can mix. It's almost white when I put it on my lips. Like, I'll show you a swatch of it. It looks like a pale baby pink, but it's just so light. I don't think this alone would look good on any skin tone, but it can be mixed with other lipsticks to lighten them. So I'll definitely use it as a lightening lipstick. I don't know why it has a little color swatch on the inside, but even the box, which I think MAC should do this with all their lipsticks, the box has the color on the outside. And they were all like that. There was five lipsticks in this collection. This I only wanted one. I didn't want to go crazy with all the other ones were like that too, where the lipstick bullet was the actual color of the lipstick. So I thought that was really cool. I just wanted one to have because I'm crazy like that. But anyway, now we have Sephora stuff. So this was a couple of different orders. So speaking of like samples and stuff, I got a, I think this was a 100-point perk. I got an Elizabeth and James Nirvana White Rollerball, like a little mini one. I love the smell of this. They only had the white. If they had the black too, I would have gotten both of them. But oh, it smells so good. It's just a little rollerball. I really like this. I might end up getting this perfume. Actually, I might buy it for my grandma for her birthday coming up because she really, I had a sample of it and like a little tiny sample, and she loved the smell of it too. It really reminds me of a stronger version of the Harajuku Lovers Love perfume, which is another one of my favorites. I'm almost out of my bottle of that, but this smells so good. And I keep seeing people talking about how great this stuff smells, so it's so awesome. It almost smells, it smell, it's very floral, so that's the best way to describe it. Like, you smell rose in it, but it's not like old lady scented rose, you know? I just really like the smell of it. So, with more samples, I also had a code to get three fresh samples. So I got the Seaberry Moisturizing Face Oil, which I've never tried before. You could also get the face wash, but I hate the face wash, so I didn't get that. A sample of the Rose Lip Treatment, which I have already, so I have a backup now, and a sample of the Advanced Therapy, Sugar Advanced Therapy, which I also have one already, so I have backups now. These, whenever they have the lip samples from Fresh, I grab them as, like, if they have a sample code or whatever, because I love this stuff, and it's like $23 for one full-size one. But these, they're good, decent-sized samples, and they last a long time. And then in a separate order, I'll just get all these samples out of the way first. I got another one of the, I think this is just the original one, the Fresh Sugar Lip Treatment. So I have a whole bunch of fresh lip treatments backed up now. I'll be all set this winter because that's like the only stuff that helps my chapped lips in the wintertime. So, oh, and then I guess I'll do this too. I got my birthday present, because my birthday is the 31st of July, so it used to be you could only get your birthday present 10 days before or after your birthday, but now it's just your whole birthday month whenever you feel like it, you can get it. So because I'm a VIB Rouge, I got the eyeliner with it, but everybody else that's a Beauty Insider gets the two NARS lip pencils. So I'm gonna show you these. I've had a sample of this before. They're, what is the exact name of it? Larger Than Life Long Wear Eyeliner. I don't really like it. It's not that great. And then the lip pencils. There is a satin lip pencil in Rikugine. Not even gonna attempt to say that. But you know what? Are these not even twist ups? I don't think these even twist up. Everybody was saying what a good size they are for a sample, but I think that's it, and they don't even twist up from here. But anyway, the one that I was just talking about is the Rikugine one, or maybe you have to sharpen it. I have no idea. Someone knows if you sharpen these or if they're supposed to be twist up. Just tell me. And this is seriously, when I put this on, my lips just look like I have gloss on because it's shiny, but it's the same color as my lips. So it is pretty. And they kind of have like that fruity, the fruity taste to them that the Bite Beauty lipsticks do. And then this other one is a velvet matte lip pencil, and it's called Cruella, and it's a really pretty red. Like a deep berry red. So that's that one right there. I really like that one so far. The other one is pretty, but it's just like the same color as my lips, so no biggie. All right, now I can get into the actual stuff I ordered. I had to get the Jaclyn Hill Whoa. Shimmering Skin Perfector from Becca. That is the highlight that I have on today. It is gorgeous. I had Opal, and people have been comparing this to Opal a lot, but I sold Opal in a blog sale because it was way too dark for me to use it as a highlight. It's like, it was too bronzy and gold for what I usually like for a highlight. But this one is lighter. Like, I'm insisting it's lighter than Opal because I can get away with using this as a highlighter and it's really, really pretty. It keeps like selling out on Sephora and then coming back, so if you haven't gotten it yet, just keep checking. But it's just a really pretty, like, light champagne, super shimmery highlight. I love it. I love Jaclyn Hill. She's one of my favorite people to watch on here, so had to get this. The only other one I have right now is Moonstone, and I love that. And then I have one of the Pored Shimmering Skin Perfectors in Pearl, and I love that one too. Those are really good if you want a cream highlighter for oily skin. Now, these other things I got were Kat Von D stuff, and I know you guys always like when I do Kat Von D videos. I did, today her metallic shadows came out, so what day am I filming this? I don't know when this is gonna go up, but today is July 16th. Crazy, and I ordered them, so as soon as those come in, I will do a video on those. But I wanted to get this out of the way because that's gonna be a long video, so I wanted to just talk about these things first. I got, and I haven't even opened this yet, the 5-year anniversary tattoo liner in Trooper. It's got such cool packaging, and it's just like encased in here in like plastic packaging, so I'm afraid to rip it. And my other Trooper liner isn't like out yet, so I'm still using that one. So I figured I'll leave this in here until I use that one. It's just the same exact liner, but it's got like a metal pen and it's got stars all over it. And you probably can't see it because it's in the plastic. There we go. That's a little bit better. Really cool. Very excited about that. And then the other day, her liquid lipsticks came out, all the new shades. So I ended up with two of them. I didn't go too crazy. I got two purplish ones. I don't know what's with me and purple lips lately, but I got Aisha and I got Requiem. And she came out with 16 new ones. So let me take off this, the Lunatic Labs lipstick. I keep losing my little Ursula mirror because Aiden loves it. He loves to look at himself in it. He keeps taking it off my desk. Okay. So, this one is Aisha, and it's. Why does it look so thick in there? It's a really unique kind of dusty purple shade. So, I'll swatch it on my hand first. Oh, yeah, that's really pretty. I don't know how it's going to look on me, but I thought this was a really pretty color. Again, they don't really have a scent to them, so. It seems creamier than the other ones that I have. I hope they last as long on the lips. So that is a really nice purple. I don't know, does it look good on me? Everybody loved that succulent ColourPop matte liquid lipstick on me, and I don't wear reds all that often, but I guess I'll have to wear that one more often. See. I love the Kat Von D lipsticks because they dry so fast. It's already dry, not sticky. I don't know. I like this color. I don't know if I like it on me though. It's not that bad actually because it's dusty, so it's not like a bright in your face purple. That is Aisha. Requiem. This one is another like. Kind of looks like that Lunatic Labs one that I got, the Lunatic Cosmetic Labs one. But let's see. Yeah, I'm gonna get a lot of use out of this one, I can tell. Look at how pretty that is. I freaking love this color. It's really, really pretty. It's like, I don't know, I think even with these two shades, they'd probably make a really pretty ombre lip. Like, put the dark color on the outer corners, and then I really like this color. I don't know. I think I like Requiem better than Aisha, but I'm gonna wear them both because they're really, really pretty. And they're stinking, what, 20 bucks a piece? But I really, really like them. They stay on all day. I cannot rave enough about the Kat Von D liquid lipsticks. I'm not gonna go into it again because you guys are probably sick of hearing me rave about them. But that is it for this haul. And like I said, I'm gonna do a video about the metallic the Metal Crush eyeshadows as soon as they come in, but I wanted to add these to that to this haul so that I wouldn't have to do a separate video just on the lipsticks. But I hope you guys enjoyed. I really like this color. Go pick up some of these new colors if you haven't yet. They're super, super pretty. They have so many new ones. Like I said, I think there's 16 new shades. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will talk to you in my next video. Don't get scared, take a chance. Don't let it slip through your hands.